Stability AI has finally released their official ControlNet LORA models. These are not only almost as good as if not better than the diffuser models, but also much smaller in size. Sadly, they are still available only in comfy UI, but luckily for us, they have made sure to provide the JSON files with the workflow for each of the ControlNet models. There are currently 4 models made available. The first one is a depth model that utilizes the grayscale depth map for guided generation. Next is the Canny edge model, which detects abrupt changes, namely edges in an image, and uses that data to create a controlled output image. Third one is Recolor, which is designed to colorize black and white photographs. The fourth one is named Sketch, which colorizes black and white sketches like magic. But the surprises does not end there. The newest addition to SDXL arsenal is Revision, that uses your images as prompts. Finally, something that can compete with Midjourney blend features. You can use multiple images together or even text prompts with images together. In today's episode, we are going to learn how you can install and run ControlNet models for SDXL in your PC. Let's start by downloading the ControlNet models from this URL. Now download the models first. Let's copy and paste them inside the WebUI folders, models, ControlNet. In my case, the Automatic 1111 and ComfyUI folders are connected. Therefore, copying them inside the Automatic 1111 folder lets me use them with ComfyUI just fine. If you want to learn how you can do the same and save your disk space, you should definitely watch the video in the description. Now you will need ControlNet preprocessors for your ComfyUI. Go to the second page here. I have given the link in the description. Down here you will find a command to do so. You don't need to copy the entirety of this one. Just copy this line from here. Now go back to your ComfyUI Windows Portable folder. Get inside Custom Nodes. Just click here. Type cmd, hit enter. Now just paste the command here and hit enter. This would create this comfy ControlNet preprocessor folder inside your custom nodes folder. Now get inside this folder, go to install.py and double click on it. It would install all the necessary files. Next, if you have been using ComfyUI for quite some time, you would be familiar with the ComfyUI manager. If not, then go to this page, download this ComfyUI manager installer from here, copy the file inside your ComfyUI Windows Portable folder and double click on it. That would install the ComfyUI manager, and if you are wondering about its purpose, you will learn in a minute. Now let's get back to the first URL and download the Control LORA workflows. Get inside this folder. Here you can see the JSON files needed to load the workflow inside ComfyUI. Just download them. Now shoot up your ComfyUI. Now let's start with loading the ControlNet workflow inside ComfyUI. Load. Here you can see the red colored node named undefined, which shows no data. Actually, this node is not available to my local ComfyUI system yet. Now if I go to the manager and click on install missing custom nodes, this would show up. Let's install this one. Now close the window and restart ComfyUI. This would take some time to install the required files there, and now that node is available to us. That is Midas depth map node. It has already fetched an image from history data. Let's write a nice prompt here. Here it has created a depth map of the portrait I provided and created a very beautiful image from that. You can compare them side by side to see how the before and after looks like. Let's change up the prompt a little bit again. And this one also looks fabulous. As I didn't specify it to be a male or female person, it has automatically created an image of a male person. But this shows very nicely the capabilities of the depth model, and the possibilities are really endless. Now let's switch over to the Canny model. Okay, we are going to use the same image from first time, then we will change it up later. There is already a prompt given, portrait of a man wearing a hat sitting in a park. Let's cue this one. Here is the Canny edges map. This one seems to have created a 2D painting or drawing like image instead of a 3D photograph or 3D model. The reason behind this might be that a Canny edges model actually detects the edges of an image. It doesn't detect the changes of distance between objects or layers like the depth model. Therefore, from a portrait of a person, it has only detected the edges, which gave a result of a 2D image from that. I think this model is going to work best with images with lots of textures or intricate details in them. You can see this image has lots of texture in them. And the result is here. Now let's move on to the next one, Recolor. They have already given a prompt. This one is so beautifully created, I can't even imagine a tool can do this automatically and within a matter of seconds. And on top of that tool is completely free and open sourced. Now let's try this image here. You can see this image has lots of textures and fine grains in it, but despite all that, this has colorized it beautifully. Now moving on to the sketch model, I'm going to use this image first. This is a beautiful image nonetheless, but it does not really resemble the sketch I uploaded. Let's try some other image. Again, this one did not turn up as expected. I think this model is designed specifically for humanoid figures. Well, not the image I expected from this one. I think I have to play a little bit more with this model to find out what really works. Let's move on to the revision model that you all have been waiting for. First, we have to download the model from this link. First, download this Clipvision Shape Tensors file from here. Also, download both the JSON files for ComfyUI workflow. Now, copy the Clipvision file inside ComfyUI Models Clipvision. And again, restart the ComfyUI. First, going with the revision basic workflow and see what variations I get from this one. Well, it has clearly taken the reference from the image, but I'm not really sure if I can call this a variation. Let's try the multi-image option. Now, this looks like a mix of both of the images a little bit. Let's play with the image weights right now. I'm going to decrease the weight of the first image to somewhere around 0.5. Now that looks like a blend between a colorful photograph and a pencil sketch. All these models released yesterday are a huge leap forward for AI image generators, especially for stable diffusion. I really like this one. We all know SDXL is not one model, rather a combination of two models, the base model and the refiner model. But none of the workflows given here combines the two models. Therefore, we are getting somehow softer images, images with a lack of detail. This next week, I am going to dedicate my time building a workflow where we can combine both the base model and refiner models along with these control net models and revision models. And as soon as possible, I'll make that workflow available for you all. And if you are new to ComfyUI and have not yet mustered up the courage to play with this one, you should definitely check out this video right here.